Alright, so here we are again. This is year 10, fight 11 of People of the Stars campaign. This year, Tyrant is coming back to our town to see how we're doing. He's upset. Jinx didn't bring cookies last year. So...
Well, he killed her.
He just killed her, yeah. So that's unfortunate. But this is one of those years where we have to go all out and attack, get those traits. There's only a few chances where you can get certain traits, and we know whoever gets the death blow is going to get either Oracle's Eye or Iridescent Hide, so...
Trying to time that perfectly.
Yeah. One thing I do want to bring up, Miss Fortune last year, she received the Mammoth Hide, the Mammoth Hunting Art. We forgot that she actually had Dragon Vestments on, so we were able to choose a Dragon Trait Fighting Art, and we went with Faded Blow instead. Just for another check off, and Faded Blow is pretty helpful.
Yes.
Because of that, actually Miss Fortune's gonna come back out. She came up, she's fighting some of the top ranks. So let's quickly show you who we're bringing out. So this time we are fighting a level 2 Tyrant. So he is a little bit stronger. He has 10 toughness, which we fought before, a level 2 lion, so we're used to that. He does have plus 1 speed and plus 1 damage, and he has a total of 15 wounds. The new trait that he has this time is quickened. So at the end of each monster's turn, the Tyrant places a gate token in his blind spot. So really, every turn he's going to have those gate tokens, and if you remember, the more gate tokens he had, the stronger his attacks were, some of his moves got triggered that way. And then I found this little card here, which I think was just a typo in under the Tyrant. This explains what the gates do. Remember, I think the first time we had this video, we were a little confused of what those little purple symbols meant. There was actually a card, but it wasn't on the Tyrant card, just our little heads up there. All right, first person, like I mentioned, is Miss Fortune. She is coming out as our Ranger. She has Champion's Right, Orator of Death, Faded Blow. It's going to be your Ranger there with two shards, the circlet, the harp, and that lucky arrow. Next is going to be Taric. He's going to be our tank. He is unbreakable. With the iridescent hide and the leather set, he's going to have 4 armor at every hit location. So hopefully he can bounce around. One good thing about him, he has monster grease, the vestments, and plus 1 evasion. So he's got 3 evasion. So hopefully he's a good dodge tank with 4 armor.
And as normal, I'll be handling the damage dealers. Hopefully they'll be doing lots and lots of damage. Bringing Annie back out to this fight as well. The last fight and the reason we brought her was to get her weapon proficiency up to get the weapon specialization for grand weapons, which is a plus 1 accuracy. And when you critically wound, the monster's knocked down, which is going to be really cool. Hopefully open up with her to help everyone else get better hits. She also gained Faded Blow, which is going to help do another damage to this guy today. And here's the second Rib Blade that we just built, so now we're dual-wielding them, which would be great. And bringing Blitz Crank from retirement a little bit. He's just strategic, so we were able to put more terrain on the tile, on the board, and using the Greater Gax, because he is proficient in axes. And we're bringing him with the shield, because we're hoping to protect him just a little bit more. And giving him the Founding Stone, in case it comes down to that last blow, we can make sure that he is the one that hopefully kills him, that critical, that automatic critical, to get more Dragon King traits.
Yep. All right. Tyrant gets one piece of terrain. The Nightmare Tree.
Oh, wonderful.
Oh, that.
All right. Well, we'll set it up and Let's set it up and see what goes on.
Yep. Okay. So we're using the Lonely Tree model here. We're probably gonna stay away from this as much as possible. It blocks line of sight. We can try and gather resources from it, but we've got another purpose here.
Yeah.
Fight.
Domination.
There you go. Domination. We do get to go first. Do you want to cut this hit location deck, Snots?
Oh, of course.
Okay.
So you can blame me when that trap comes. There you go.
First thing is, I'm going to go with Miss Fortune. We're going to shoot the arrow right into this Tyrant. And hopefully that helps us throughout the entire fight.
Yeah.
Okay. Now she is Quixotic, so she has 2 plus 2 strength tokens.
That's awesome.
That's pretty cool, right? All right. Sorry, I'm a little nervous here. So I'm gonna use Champion's Right. So because I'm on top of the pillar and Champion's Right, I hit
twos.
On a two.
Yeah.
Firing my arrow. It is a hit. It is not the trap, so he gets minus one evasion.
All right.
Okay, just get that out of the way. The Celestial Robes. If this I wound him, he performs Crooked Step.
Already?
Already.
Come on.
So
miss.
I'm going to... Don't miss. I'm going to use my Fated Blow right here.
Okay.
Plus two strength, and I do two wounds to him. So I'm going to activate my Fated Blow. So the strength of this is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I wound on a 2.
Okay.
Whew. 3. So that is two wounds.
Yeah, well, he's crooked stepping already.
He's going to be crooked stepping
all the time.
But
we were hoping, I was hoping just to beat the crap out of him.
Tell him what you were hoping while I get the token.
I just wanted to have everyone, because we have three people with Fated Blows, so I was hoping to get all three people this first round just converge on him. 2, 4, 6 damage first turn and render him really like hurt. Render him hurt.
Yeah.
Immobile. Maybe knock him down with a critical on this, but now he's moving already.
Hey, I'll take two wounds.
Oh, me too. I'm not gonna.
Crooked step, let's double check. Place a gate token on the monster's current space. At least you can get to it. And then 6 spaces away from the furthest survivor from it. So, it's gonna be from him. So we're gonna put him, where do we wanna put him?
Put him anywhere.
Well, it's gonna be the furthest down there, so that means she's not gonna be able to get the attack.
Mm-hmm.
So who?
6 furthest from what, the temp?
The person.
Of who?
Who we get to pick.
Oh, okay.
Place the gate token. Okay. Then place the monster 6 spaces away from the furthest survivor from it. Well, since that's where she's leaving. Yeah, we're all the same. You're going to come over here and probably knock it down then.
Okay.
And then is the tyrant going to go back in this corner near the tank?
Hmm.
And then maybe we all clump together?
Or do we... Yeah, because we don't want to put him in the tree. It's kind of a...
Right.
Okay, I guess... Or do you put him over here and shoot him with the bow?
I just attacked.
No, like next turn.
Oh.
Or you think he's going to crook us up again?
Yeah, he's going to be jumping around. And I don't want to put him out here.
No. Okay.
Yeah, because you're not going to be able to get to him. So.
Right.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right. That's it.
Okay.
1 gate token down. And Misfortune.
Did her job.
Yeah, I want to move 1 step closer.
Yeah, why not just... Oh, yeah. Cause
I understand.
We're all just going to come this way.
Yeah, we're all going to
mm-hmm.
head this way.
Yeah.
Okay. You want to go first with the...
Yeah, I'll
the
go
Gaxen, for, okay. Try and knock that gate down.
Yeah.
Because well, who knows, you might even teleport over
that's
there.
That's what I'm saying, too. If I teleport over here, then it's... You know, we have to keep moving.
2, 3, 4, 5.
I'm going to go here.
Yeah. Okay. Now you roll a d10, but because you have something heavy as your weapon, you get to roll an additional d10.
Okay.
8. Okay, smashing success. You step through the gate, place your survivor adjacent to the monster. Archive the terrain tile.
So I'm going to bring him this way. Because we're hoping he's going to teleport this way, so I'm going to move closer. Or should I go behind? You know, like, I'm not facing.
I think that's fine. I think you're okay.
Trying to stay away from him. Yeah, trying to stay closer to this where we're going to fight.
So that's kind of unfortunate.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? Why don't I go with the tank next to headband, and we'll see what the things are, because that might determine what you do with movement for both of us.
Okay.
Unseen horror. And, okay, so remember, all the moods were the ones that were in place, right? So... when this comes into play, perform basic action. So his basic action is random threat in range. So his movement is 6, so it would be the two of us down there. Speed, so it's going to be 3 attacks, hits on 3s, damage 3. So that's a lot.
Yeah, it's rough.
And you wouldn't be able to dash away from there.
Right.
He's going to get you.
So maybe that's not the best thing. So Unseen Horror, closest threat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which it could be me. In field of view. So it'd be 3 speed, 5 accuracy, but I would have +3 evasion, so it would hit me on 8, 3 damage. For each severe injury suffered, oh, I think we're going to do that, because I'm not going to suffer any severe injuries.
Hopefully, yeah.
So I think that's going to go on top.
Okay.
Let's get this mood
out of the way.
Out of the way. Put that on the bottom. And then after this, it's going to perform Crooked Step, meaning it's going to go towards the furthest person.
Okay. So we're going to have 2 portals this turn.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. So I said you... This is where he's going to teleport.
Yeah. So I want to get close.
Yeah. So I'm going to... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we're just going to move you.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then 6. It's the end of your turn.
Yeah. Do I dash?
Yeah, I don't know. If you dash, then he's going to come over here.
Yeah.
12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So it's going to be you, and he's probably going to appear over here. So you could attack him next turn.
Mm-hmm. With one person, yeah.
One person. I think that's what...
Which might be okay, because if we do that, we set that up so that she hits next turn.
He's going to teleport back.
The Gax is going to hit. Gax hopefully will break a portal.
Right.
Teleport next to him.
Yeah.
But we'll have another portal over here that I'm not going to be able to handle.
Okay.
Because it's going to be all the way really far.
Yeah.
Or, I wonder if the order is, he's in a crooked step first. So he drops a portal, I'll break that, and then when he stops his turn, there will be 2 over there.
Quicken, at the end of each monster's turn.
Yeah, so he'll already be over there.
The tyrant places again. Yeah, he'll be over there. 2. That's when he places another portal.
Yeah, so there'll be one over there, one here, one there. So it's not bad.
Yeah. Okay. This is gonna be.
Let's do it.
Him jumping all over places is rough. We have really to get bad. All in one corner.
Yeah, we have to get together, but it's impossible.
I should have gotten her closer. Then he would have spawned over here.
Possibly. Yeah.
It's like maybe we just keep trying to. Instead of you going to attack, we just push over here, but then there's a portal sitting by itself. I don't know if that's...
Because then even if we're close, yeah, we have... Yeah.
Because if he's close, he would just be keep teleporting this way.
Mm-hmm.
If we're all in one corner.
Well, no, we're not going to all be able to attack.
But, yeah, because you're going to destroy the portal, and you're going to teleport to that portal anyway. You're going to teleport to him, which is far away, so... Yeah. I think it's whenever we get an attack,
we have to damage. Plan this. We have to plan it like this. I think this is good.
Okay. So you just move. You're not dashing.
No.
Right.
And you're moving my 1 extra this way, right?
I did. Okay. I did. You were here, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah, let's do that. You can't.
He would be here. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, so he'll be here.
Okay.
Okay, that's it, right? Unfortunately. Monster's turn. He's attacking the tank, so I'm gonna gain +1. Okay, so, it's 4 speed. It's 4 attacks on this thing. Accuracy 5, 6, 7, 8. One hit. Let's see where it is, but I'm probably gonna dodge it anyway. The hand. Instead of taking 3 damage, I think I'm just going to spend a dodge now.
Okay.
And try and get it back.
Yeah.
So you all have 5.
5 survival.
Don't. I lose it. Okay. So that's my 1 dodge. Okay. Perform Crooked Step. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right. The end of the monster's turn, it performs Quickened. There's the second gate. All right. That's it. Our turn.
I'm going to go first.
Go in and attack him?
Yeah.
What? How about this?
Okay.
If I can't attack from here, do I hit, circle it?
Oh, yeah, true. Can? Oh, you can't. That's too far.
I'll circle it and then, like, move.
Okay.
Just maybe we can get rid of hit locations that do crooked step or whatnot.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm gonna circle it.
Oh, good thing you circled.
Well, there's the trap card.
There's the trap. Okay, that's good.
Okay. All right, reflex, perform crooked step. They're both perform crooked step on reflexes. And that's going to teleport him back over here.
Yeah.
In the corner. Or maybe over here. Six monsters away from the furthest survivor from it, as far from the other survivor as possible. So he'll be right in the corner.
Okay.
If he crooked steps again.
Okay. That's furthest away?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now.
What's the one that if I crit, it doesn't stop that? Is there something on there?
Attacker gains extra. You'll gain survival. Replace the definition of renesate with
resonant.
Yeah. Target gains insanity. So that's probably the one you want to go after.
Okay.
So it's either do we do wounds? We don't want to pop this.
No.
We would want to pop it early.
Or just keeping it down.
Keeping it down.
I mean, then we play the game, we know where it is.
Yeah. Okay, well, I think this is just how it's going to be.
And we're only going to ever really get one attack, I think.
True. If she just keeps using the circlet. Okay. We're going to do that.
Okay.
Yeah, that's a good point.
I'm going to have multiple people. Yeah.
Okay. So he's there. You can hit him twice.
Okay.
I'm going to move, though. I'm going to move closer.
Do you want to wait?
I can't.
Oh, you're
because that was
your
my,
turn.
That was my turn.
Because what's going to happen is I'm going to hit this and possibly teleport to wherever he is.
You're going
to
go here first.
No, I'm saying after this.
Right.
Like, say I hit him and he's going to crooked step, he's going to go somewhere else.
He's going to go here.
Okay. Oh, then I'll end up over here.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think that's it.
Okay.
You're going to push in?
Let's go. Please.
Oh, you know what he was supposed to do when he attacked me? He was supposed to move three spaces away.
Okay, so then it's...
So just that's where the gate is.
Okay.
Yep. Okay. All right, so you get two attacks.
Two hits, because I'm using ambidextrous rib blades.
So you hit on a six, you hit on a five because you're proficient, you hit on fours because of the evasions.
One hit.
Okay, celestial breastplate. Are you using your
faded
blow? Okay, so plus two strength on this.
Yes.
So the strength is five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Okay.
So you wound on a two. Nice.
Cool. So it's devastating.
So it's two wounds.
Two wounds. Flipping it over.
Okay. Give me... I think there may be Pokemon nearby.
Oh, man. All right. So a little break.
Yeah. All right, so we lost the cell phone out for some Pokemon hunting, so there's no music, but I think it'll be okay. Maybe I'll put some in. But we just did the two extra wounds to him.
Yes.
Which is great. Now his reflex is perform crooked step.
Yeah.
So he is going to be teleporting the furthest away here, then he can only go in this corner.
Okay.
That's it. And you have to put a...
Where he
leaves, right? Yeah. Why do I always forget this? So there's two here now.
Yeah, it's gonna stink.
Does stink. Okay. That's it. Obstacle impassable. Okay, so yeah, he can go on top of it. Alright. So we still have... That was two people, so we still have the tank and Blitz to go, right? So we want Blitz to break it? To break that?
Or do you want headband?
Or am I headbanding? I can headband now.
Yeah.
It's not going to change anything. But I can't get in front of him. I won't be able to stand here.
Do you want me to break the thing first? With the Gax?
That's what I'm thinking.
And then just see what happens from there? I mean, I'm going to teleport in front of him. Then you can move in front. Because if I teleport next to him, I'm going to be
right
here.
Yeah, because you're going to teleport. Yeah, you're absolutely right.
Should I go here? I can attack from two away. So should I go one, two, three...
Yes.
Four?
Yeah.
Five?
That's a good spot. Can you get there?
Yeah, that's
cool.
Five.
Okay. Two dice on the gate.
That's
sweet. Perfect. So you gain plus one survival. Because remember, you want to spend survival.
Oh man, yeah, I didn't know
you're gonna be getting that. So dashing a lot would be good.
Yeah.
And this gets destroyed. Get rid of that. Place your server adjacent to the monster in that corner. Cool. Okay. Yeah, see, if we had
Surge, double attacks, yeah.
That would be
But dash was so much more better.
Absolutely.
So just, much better.
Since then, too bad we haven't gotten it.
Again, yeah, yeah.
No. Okay. Headband.
Yeah.
Taric, let's see. Enshrine and Blistering Star. So here's the mood card, Blistering Star, so we probably don't want that. If we can get rid of all the mood cards that use
the portals, then we can say screw the portals.
Then we don't really need to, who cares if they're all out?
Yeah.
So let's try not to have that mood come out.
Okay.
And let's just look at this. Closest threat in field of view.
So hopefully be a tank.
So hopefully it will be my tank. In range. Closest survivor in range. Okay, so move into range and attack. So he might actually walk through me, because I think Tyrant gains 3 range. A Tyrant can attack a target. When the monster is instructed to move into range, and the monster's move 3 spaces away from the target.
Okay.
So he will have to walk over me.
Which does?
It knocks me down.
Okay.
But that's not that big of a deal, because someone could always encourage me up next turn. Okay. So what this does is...
But then does he hit you when he knocks
He's still going to attack me.
Okay.
Yep. 3 speed, so again, it's going to hit me on 8s. It's going to be 3 damage apiece.
And you
so
still have the same attack. You still are armored and everything while you're knocked down.
Yep. Then, after this, he does not crooked step.
Okay.
Place 1... Oh my god. I'm going to be placing 3 gates down. All right there. But that means he doesn't crooked step.
Yeah.
Which is helpful. And plus, we want that instead of this, because this mood is... he's just going to be attacking us. 4 speed, 2 damage apiece. We don't want that in play. So let's just have that. He's going to have a lot of gates down. But now, hopefully, we're all close together. Okay. And now I have to move here.
Okay.
All right. So this switches. Monster's turn. Closest threat in field of view. He has to move within range, so it's going to be 1, 2, it's going to be 3 away. He knocks me down. Let me double check. So now that we're fighting all the way in the corner there, it's not.
Yeah.
I double check that out. All that's on camera. Considering we're not going to be. Oh, it is. We're just in the corner there. There we go. So at least people can see what's going on, right?
That's so, most important.
That's the whole point.
I'm retreating on the gates because I don't have a heavy weapon.
With her.
Annie. Yeah, it's just going to be a 1 die.
But at least it gets you teleported over there.
Hopefully. Right? Yeah.
All right. And then he's going to attack me now that I'm on the ground. So it's 4 speed hitting on 8s here. All misses.
Oh, that's wonderful.
That extra evasion.
That's really, yeah.
Really helpful. Crap. All right. And now he's going to place... So it's his level, which is 2, plus 1 in unoccupied spaces. So it's here, here. Oh. I wonder if I can't put this down.
Oh, because it has to be in the corners of them?
Place, yeah, terrain tiles in unoccupied spaces in the shrine zone. Hmm, so it's his literally corner. So I can't place one here or here. So I wonder if it just comes in. Otherwise, place it on the nearest unoccupied. They all say nearest unoccupied, so I think it's best to do that. All right, well, we survived 2 turns. Now there's a lot of gates. And we know that this top AI card has gates coming in, so we want to make sure we do some damage.
Now, I'm reading a gate from 1 through 6. I don't do anything.
Right.
So it's 7, 8, 9, 10. 40% chance of coming over here. A 6, I destroy it, but I also take damage. I'll take 2 damage to 2 locations. Mm. So do I just run?
You just, like, get over there.
Run over there, forget the portals, and run over there.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Dash. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Move 1. That might actually be better.
Yeah, right? And I... Yeah.
Now we know we've got 1 more card than the trap, right?
Yeah.
And now the trap's doing 5 damage. So we've got a circlet with her. And can you...
He's going to go over and...
You could attack.
Him or the portal?
Not the
thing,
portal.
The thing is, if I hit him for 2 damage, the trap comes out.
Well, yeah, I would have the circlet first.
Mm-hmm.
And then have Blitz go to attack.
Okay. I'm afraid that I'm afraid there's an attack in there that's going to utilize the portals as, like, its strength.
Yeah, no.
I don't remember.
But now I think the portals are kind of out of hand.
Yeah. We know where the trap is, so we're okay there. And if we keep doing... If we keep headbanding, we can move the moods down. Hopefully we don't get 2 moods at the same time.
Right.
But we can move them, you know, so...
I think we have to start with the head... The circlet. Okay. So that's her good step. Mm-hmm. The trap... Perform resonate. Resonate target suffers gate brain damage.
Yeah, see.
If they suffer 5 or more, they gain destined.
Yeah, but you're gonna get blown up.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How much brain damage do we have here?
He's got 0 on brain and blitz.
Oh. Okay. So we can't really do that.
Yeah.
I've got 3, 3.
12 on Annie. 12 brain.
Annie could actually do it. Oh, man. If you critical, you can gain frozen star seeker fighting art. Well, if you gain the... If you have to roll on the chart, you can't die from it.
From brain damage?
From brain damage.
Okay.
Can't die from it because we have accept darkness.
Okay.
But it could affect other things, of course. Would Destin do anything for... He's already Destin, isn't he?
Destin, yeah.
No, so that does not help.
Does not help.
Does Destin help anybody else?
He does have a skull helm, so instead of suffering a severe head damage, he would blow the helm up. But that's not, it's brain damage.
Right,
it's not
right.
Different. I forgot.
Destin disorder, no. Okay. 1, 2. Well, if you hit the gate, we're not doing any damage on this round.
That's if both hit, you know. Hopefully they hit, but...
Right. We gotta do wounds.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. What are you thinking?
I don't know. I want to do wounds to him, but... Maybe we do that. And we just do the crooked step one.
Oh, you know what? Crooked step goes first. Yeah, he's going to teleport. You're not going to be able to hit him again. Good call.
Okay.
So I'll put that on top. So that's that. I think I'm going to have Misfortune encourage Taric to stand up now.
Why? Why does he need to stand up? To move?
Okay. Yeah, to do anything. But I'll wait for you to go first.
Okay.
So Misfortune can still move now, though. So I should probably get closer this way.
Yeah, right? Hopefully. That's what we're going to hope to do. Or because she's only going to be around here.
Oh, right.
So maybe don't get too far.
This.
Yeah.
I'll come here.
Still want to be within range, you know.
Yeah. Let's do that.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1. 1.
Yeah. Okay.
So you're going to go try and do a wound here.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah.
And you can attack from that far.
Yep, cool. Because the Gax is reach.
Yep.
Okay.
Ooh.
2. Hits on 6.
There's no way you're hitting.
Accuracy. Evasion.
5, 4. Yeah. Okay. Well, then now I think you're going to move in that dash. I'm actually stand up and headband.
Okay.
So I'm going to encourage. Misfortune's going to encourage. Tank to stand up. And now I'm going to headband. Oh, and there's another mood. Oh, because we haven't done a wound yet. Okay. Mercury Eyes. Closest threat in field of view. In range. It's going to be me again. It's the same thing. Target suffers 1d... Target suffers rolls 1d10. If the result is greater than the understanding, the survivor... They suffer the flea brain trauma. Guess we should look and see what that is.
Yeah, that's a good one.
That's not right. flee. You are knocked down and suffer knockback equal to your movement towards the closest border edge and gain 1d5 insanity. Not that bad at all.
That's not that bad. How much damage does it do?
It does, it's the same as all the other attacks. Okay. It's going to hit me on 8, 3 damage apiece. So I'm just going to move in and take that hit.
Okay.
It does not, he does not crooked step after this either. Mm-hmm. So I think this is our turn now to just get over there.
Hopefully, yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
Do that.
There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 1 dashing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At the end of my turn, I can move one more because of the leather boots.
Yes.
So now we're all pretty close to him. But, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so she's the furthest. So he's going to come out around here somewhere.
Yeah.
So do I even bother that? Do I do this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No,
remember,
I'm the furthest.
Oh, you remember. He's going to go here. 1, 2, 3.
To hit you.
So he's going to be here, which is going to be
which is the
good.
Furthest here.
Right.
So he's still coming over here?
Yeah, if he crooked steps.
Okay.
So this is a good spot, I think.
Yeah.
That's where it was. All right. That's it. Okay. Just, these gates are scary.
Yeah.
But here's a way to get a lot of destins.
Hopefully.
All right. Monster's turn. We know what it is. Break your eye. Closest threat. It's going to move down here. 1, 2, 3. You're gonna roll, so this is 4 attacks, hitting me on 8.
One hit.
See where it hits me. But I'm pretty sure I'm dodging.
Waste.
I'm gonna dodge. Then dodge, let's see if I get it back. I don't. Okay, I can only do that a few more times.
Yeah.
Alright, Mercury Eye is done. You know what? Now the gate comes in. Remember, end of the monster's turn.
Yep, right here.
It is in the monster's blind spot. If possible, otherwise place the nearest unoccupied space adjacent to the monster. Right there.
Ooh, that blows. Gotta run around that now, right?
Yeah, now you might have to break it down just for vision.
Yeah.
But I think, well, we know still what's on top. It's still 2 cards, right? Because you missed both.
Yeah.
Okay, so I don't have to circle it this time.
Right. Not yet.
Not yet.
Yeah.
But I think we have Annie.
So it's our turn now.
It's our turn.
Oh, yeah. Annie's going to hit right from here. Or does she move?
I think you might get behind and attack.
1, 2.
Get those accuracies. So you hitting on 6s, 5s from behind, 4 proficient, 3s because of the evasion.
Okay.
Perfect hit. Doesn't do anything, right? All right. So we're gonna do the first one. It's gonna crooked step into that corner.
Okay.
Six is a wound. Reflex, perform crooked step.
We have no more portals.
We have no more portals. I think 6 is the
six
most.
6 is max. It
goes there. And you don't get to attack the second one. Okay. Trap is on top.
Yeah. Now I'm going to move this way. 1.
Okay. Cool. Let me double check if I have all the gates, if they really are 6.
I think it says 6 on one of his things. But there is only 6.
Yeah, that's what it looks like. All right. So it's always 6 here.
Yeah.
We did one wound.
Oh, God, that's it.
All right. So now...
You circle it, and then we go in with the Gax and hit him.
Yeah.
Well, that's the thing, too. If we hit him, we want to do some damage, but
well,
if he crooked steps, he's going to go over here and then over here.
Or do you break this one right here?
Yeah, I don't know. Because, I mean, say we don't need to break it now. Say we hit him.
Yeah, you want to do wounds? Oh, well, I have to circle it.
If you circle it, then I can come up. I can hit him from right here.
Right. Let's circle it just to see what the reactions are, too.
Okay.
So... Okay, we got a first strike. We got 2 first strikes. Okay, so here are the ones where you actually can gain stuff.
Okay.
The attacker suffers -1 strength to wound dislocation for each dragon trait they possess. Both of them.
That's 4.
Wow. Okay. Let's just see. If you wound, you get reincarnated +1 understanding, which he does not need.
No.
Would noble help?
Yes.
Would it help?
Like, well, he doesn't have it.
Majorly.
He's got, no, nothing would help majorly. He has one in rust already.
Okay. Because this is when we would want to do it to throw a shard. Like, if one of these was scar, we want him to get it.
Right.
So we really don't need any either of these.
Well, we could use noble.
It's like someone else could use it.
But you also suffer brain damage, which is bad. He doesn't have any, he has nothing.
Hmm. Two brain damage. Subject's two brain
he's
damage.
He's got zero.
Okay. So then I think he should do the gate.
Just
then.
The gate then, yeah.
And then, oh, Taric still, I have to do this.
Yep.
But now we know it's going to be noble and reincarnated.
So do you want to set up Annie then? Set Annie's attack up with that?
Yeah. Would noble or reincarnated be better
she
for her?
She already has reincarnated.
So noble's going to go on top. Okay. And now I'm just going to move a little bit closer.
Okay.
Okay. Now,
I'll hit with the gax.
Take that gate down.
Hopefully, yeah.
Yeah.
4 to stop.
4. Suffer bash and 2 damage to 2 hit locations.
Oh,
archive the terrain. It does get destroyed. The waist and the legs.
Oh, thank goodness.
Yikes.
So I have nothing on my legs, I have one in waist, and what is bashed in?
Knock down. Okay. Now I'm gonna headband. There it is. 2 moods. Both perform basic action. At the start of the monster's turn, if 2 or more heal 2 wounds, then discard this card.
Oh boy.
The other one's with 3. At the start of the monster's turn, if 3 or more place the tyrant in the center of the showdown board. All survivors suffer knockback 20 away from it, then suffer damage equal to the number of spaces they move to 2 hit locations.
Oh, so you're dead.
So what we could actually do is have everyone dash to edges.
We've already... Okay.
Everyone can dash right now.
Okay.
And we take no damage.
And it goes away? Or what?
Then this gets discarded.
Oh, discarded, not...
Yeah, it does, right, just gets discarded. Rather than healing 2, we don't want that at all.
Right.
Perform basic action. This would happen at the start of the monster's turn, so next turn, this would come into play.
Okay.
So we can set up for it.
Okay.
Right. So it's going to perform basic action, which again is random threat in range. If there's no target, we advance. Perform crooked step. Full move the monster towards the closest survivor. So if no one's within range here, he's going to crooked step towards the closest. So if you just dash away, he'll come back over to the corner. And then all we need to do is these will block, so we can suffer knockback into those.
Yeah, but you get hurt with that. Right? That's the thing. Because tumble exists, so you don't take damage.
Running into a pillar, you take damage. Obstacles, impassable. Let me just double check.
Yeah.
Stone columns, destructible. These are destructible. When a survivor collides with it, their movement ends, and you take 1 damage to a random hit location. These are not destructible. So this just counts as you can't move anymore.
Okay.
So if we suffer knockback, all survivors suffer 20, knockback 20 away from it.
No, he'd be still in the center.
Oh, sorry. At the start of the monster's turn, place the tyrant in the center. Oh, you know what? He doesn't start at the center of the board, so he's going to perform basic action right where he is.
Okay.
Sorry, this is a little confusing. Random threat in range, which is, I think, is everybody.
Everybody.
Then he performs crooked step at the end. So he may go... I don't know, he might be over here. Well, no matter what, I think this has to go.
Okay. This is one we're doing.
This is one we're doing.
So this turn, he teleports in the center and does the blowback.
The start of his next turn, he's going
to
do it.
So not this turn. We'll still be able to go.
Right.
Okay.
When this comes into play, it's going to perform basic action right now. Then it's going to crooked step. So I think that's it. I'm gonna stay where I am. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh yeah, he can hit anybody because he's got plus 3 range.
Yeah.
Okay. That's it. So monster's turn. Basic action. We're gonna randomize this way. 1, 2, 3, 4.
And okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's gonna go here. So I could just dash. Crooked Step is gonna go.
He can go on top of portals.
He can. He can. So why would he have went that way, right? Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good call. Alright, so now he's going to attack. You could actually...
I could possibly dodge away.
You could have just dashed away, because he can't get any further. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. If you dash there, you're fine.
I could dash here. 1, 2, 3. Oh boy, Bumbly. Okay.
Now what he's going to do is he's going to perform Crooked Step and appear over here. He's here. And then I guess you go in and attack him.
And then I have to dash
again. And then dash that way.
But can I dash? I don't remember.
Oh, no, yeah, you can't dash twice. So either you take the hit here.
Which is
3 attacks. Hits on 3s, 4s, 5s. 3 damage apiece.
I'll dash here.
Really?
Dude, I'm going to take 3 damage? Oh, 3 damage. I can take it to 1 hit, but I can't take...
Right, well, you can dodge.
Yeah.
You can dodge one of them. You don't have any extra evasion, right?
No. If he hits the same location, I'm in trouble.
Or... Oops, that's not right. All survivors that were then suffer damage equal number of hit locations. Or else you're going to be... Let's say he was here, right? You can move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, attack. You take 3 damage to 2 locations.
Which is even worse. It's just less, but not by much.
I would say you take the hit.
Yeah?
Yeah. Because you suffer bash, which you're immune to. Mm-hmm. I could just roll and not hit.
Yeah.
And dodge one of them. Whereas that, you're...
Guaranteed.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I think you were here, right?
1, 2, 3, yeah.
Did this move?
Well, he would then be here. No, this would go to Annie.
No, it's here. 3-way. 1, 2, 3.
Oh, okay.
It's on Annie?
I think so. I don't know.
So you gain 1 on Saturday. So I hit on 5s. Yeah, so there you go. All 3. Damn. 3 hits. So you dodge a body.
Yep.
And the hand and the body.
Okay. Down the 1 armor in both of those. 4 in the rest.
You suffer bash, but you're immune to bash.
Immune to bash because of leather armor.
And now basic action, perform Crooked Step. So it puts down a... We have another... Yeah, we do. So it's going to go here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now he would drop another portal at the end of his turn, but that's it.
I don't have any more, yeah.
All right, so now this is in play. So at the end of his turn, sorry, at the start of his turn, he's going to push us all back. So we have to be on an edge, really.
Or you could be here, too, no?
Correct.
He's going to go towards the center?
He's going to go towards the center and then push.
Okay, so you could be here, so, and you're fine.
Yeah.
That's not bad.
Trap is on top, correct?
I think so.
So I'm going to circle it first.
I think so.
Circle it first and then go here.
I don't remember.
I think so. That's what I'm going to do.
Okay.
Circle it. Oh, no, it's on.
No, yeah, I think we already did that. Because you were setting her up.
Oh, damn. I could have tried to get rid of that mood.
Oh, yeah, you could have.
The heart. Oh, I guess we all remember that. And then I'm just going to move here.
What does the harp do? Gets rid of
a mood in play. It's a 7 or more.
Here.
Yeah.
Okay.
I guess you go in and attack. See if we can do some... Some wounds here.
Okay.
Two hits. Okay. Let's do...
I have lots of brain damage. Brain armor, whatever you want to call it.
Let's 13. Do this one. Do you have reincarnated renewable already?
I have reincarnated. Let's not... Yeah.
I guess it doesn't really matter. If you fail here, you get knocked down, and then you won't be able to dash. So let's do this one.
Okay. That's a critical.
That's a critical. Awesome. There's no criticals on this card.
But it hits him. It's a damage.
Is it? Right? You have minus four. You have minus... How many traits do you have?
Oh, on her? Three.
So it's minus three strength.
Okay.
So strength of the weapon is five.
Five.
So it's really only two. Plus nine, 11. So that's a wound.
Okay.
Okay. He gained reincarnated surname, plus one understanding.
Okay. Which is zero, or one now.
Okay. You take two brain damage.
Down to 11.
Archive this card. And that's a wound.
Okay.
Okay. Now you could go again.
Six.
So again, it was five minus three is
two.
8 plus one, 9 plus one, 10.
Yeah.
So you wound him again.
Right, because a red fist and the plus one strength.
Wow, that was, I didn't think we would get two wounds on that.
Okay.
Okay.
So now we have to remember this is the trap coming up in the hit locations.
Yes, it is. Okay. He looks at you with loving benediction. Gain the noble surname.
Okay, now I have four.
Plus one courage.
Four courage as well.
And two brain damage.
Down to nine.
That was like the best one to do that with.
Yeah, it was good.
Okay, trap is on top. She's going to have to dash.
Yeah.
Let's move you here, right?
Do I want to dash like maybe one, two, three, four, five?
Yeah, that might be a good idea.
One, two, three, four, five.
Okay. So let's spend that, right?
Closer to the group.
That. Dash. We still have these two people to go. You just try and break a gate?
Yeah, I'm gonna, why not?
Right?
I mean, I can get hurt again, it's a problem, but...
Yeah, that's just a crappy roll, you know?
Yeah.
Maybe this one? Or this one?
I think that one.
This one? Well, you can do it without... You could go here and attack this, and they won't have to dash. You know, if you go here, you have to move here, then you're gonna take one damage.
Oh, I understand.
You know
okay.
What I mean?
Gotcha.
To two hit locations. Yeah, yeah, let's just take that one down.
Okay.
Not good. You failed to accomplish anything.
Okay, good. Thank
you. Whew. Wow. Okay. Now I'm gonna headband.
Yeah.
Got a mood. Which we're probably not gonna do. Okay. The other one is all threats facing. So he's gonna appear here, and so it's gonna hit everybody. This card, Intimidate. Roll 1d10 for each target. If the result is greater than their understanding, target suffers brain damage. Suffers two brain damage.
Okay.
And knock back X spaces towards the monster. That's actually pretty cool.
Yeah. Blitz has zero insanity.
Okay, so he would have to roll.
He's got the max understanding, though.
Oh, so that's great. So I think that's what we do.
Which is what, 9?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's what we're going to do then. Okay. And now I'm going to... So he's going to appear here. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think this is where I... I'm going to just go here. 2. I think that's the
same. You don't want to go here to get hit back into this?
I think I would get... I don't know which way I would get pushed.
I would assume... I'm not even drawing a line, yeah. You know? Like,
I guess I would get pushed that way. Because I can't go this way, I would get hurt. I would crash into him.
Okay.
So this way he's facing, he gets pushed. I think I would be this way.
That's what I think. If you could do diagonals...
Right, I'm just going to go there to play it safe.
Yep.
Okay, that's it. Monster's turn. So, at the start of the monster's turn, there's three or more, which there are. He goes to the center. Oh, cool, we don't even fall down. All stars suffer knockback 20 away from it, then suffer damage equal number of spaces they move to that many hit locations, which is zero.
Zero.
Discard this card.
Cool.
Monster goes. Who's over here? All threats facing, which is everybody. Now each one of them has to roll. And we want the knockback towards.
Mm-hmm.
And we would get... So we would suffer two brain damage and knock back 6 spaces towards the monster. That's pretty helpful. So let's go over here. 4 understanding, so I come closer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. Taric, 3 understanding, so he stays there.
Cool. He doesn't want to take damage, you know?
Right.
And he has 1 understanding, so.
So she takes brain damage. Misfortune also took 2, yep.
Okay, so we're at 7.
And she moves forward 6. Okay.
And then Blitz.
It's fine. Okay. That's it.
Cool.
End of the monster's turn. She places a thing down, but we don't have any more.
Oh, okay. Wait. I wonder if we could do this. I don't know if I remember if I gained any. Because he has the peerless. When you gain insanity, you gain a survival. Oh,
You haven't gained insanity.
I'm thinking of gaining survival.
Okay. So it's our turn again. Trap is on top, so I have to circle it.
Mm-hmm.
There's another one of those traits. And it's reincarnated, so I'm going to put the other one on top.
Absolutely.
Target suffers 6 brain damage. If they suffer 5 or more, they gain destined. Can you suffer 6 brain damage? Could, only one more time.
Yeah.
Or do we do the other one?
I just want to survive. We still have a lot to go.
So this one first?
Yeah. Right, what do you take?
If you fail, you get knocked back 5.
And then if you wound it...
Plus 1 understanding. And suffer then, 2 brain damage.
Okay, yeah, I'd rather do that. I just want to try to survive at this point.
Okay.
We're getting kind of... The tank has just a few more, you know, like...
Yeah. Okay. And should I move back that way?
I was still...
Or actually, this is a good spot for me, I think.
Maybe, yeah.
Okay.
Because I'm going to hit and then move here, maybe.
Or like you might want to head that way.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Keep drawing him closer.
Mm-hmm. So I might go do this.
Because if he steps right now, he's gonna come over here. Yeah.
Right, that's what we want. All right, so maybe you attack now.
Yeah. Should I move behind him or stay? I'm gonna stay in front of him.
Yeah, and then you can move after.
Yeah. Okay, so with the rib blade.
One hit.
Threes don't hit. 3, 6.
Okay. 7. So here it is. So you have 4 traits now, right?
Hmm.
Okay. So that's really
2.
Strength 1, 7, 8, 9. Right, you don't have any extra strength, right?
No. That's it.
Miss it by 1. Okay. So failure, knock back 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Alright, so we have 1 more card on here, but I don't think we're actually wounding. Maybe you would gate this again?
I'm gonna try to, right?
Yeah.
But then if I appear next to him.
Okay. Yeah,
which is fine,
don't.
Right? Because this is still the furthest. I mean, we keep breaking these gates, he's gonna keep spawning them other places.
Alright, yeah, maybe you don't do anything.
Yeah.
This is Blitz, right?
I could throw a moving bone dart him, maybe.
And this one is. Oh, there's no critical reactions to this.
No.
It is a wound, though.
Oh, no. How many wounds? How many did I do? 2? Or I did 1? Oh yeah, there's a critical on that.
No,
isn't there?
I don't think there is. Okay. Oh, there is.
We don't know what it is though.
Yeah.
I say just I'll bone dart him anyway.
Yeah.
Try to bone dart
for a wound. Yeah. Hey, we're.
Why not?
We've got the bone darts, right?
Yeah. What's the range? 6?
It's unlimited. Oh, you mean bone dart?
Yeah.
Sorry, I thought like shard.
Oh no! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can actually get here
and throw it.
Throw a dart at him, like, just to get some damage on him.
Yeah, I wish I knew what that crit was. I think it was noble, but hey, let's just try and do a wound. I think bone dart's the right thing to do.
Okay, here we go.
You have plus one accuracy, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So that's a hit.
Frozen Star!
Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. So it's a wound.
Okay.
Wow, would Frozen Star have helped you at all?
Oh, of course, it helps everybody.
Like, line up right greatly?
No, it would have been like a second one.
Hey, I'll take the wound though. Good job.
Yeah, the wound's good.
Good job.
Got dark.
Can you put that light on?
I turned it off.
Oh man, Frozen Star.
See, you should have read that. It's your fault.
That is my fault.
As team leader.
Ah. Okay. Hey, good job on the wound though.
Yeah, we got a wound. Let's focus on
so
that.
So we only have one mood left that uses the gates.
Okay. So look at the rest of it. I mean, yeah. Get off the headband once we get rid of that mood then.
Kind of,
yeah, yeah.
So we have the mood. This is the knockback one.
That can destroy us.
This is the intimidate, which it pulls us forward. The mercury guy, four attacks, hits on eights, threes. The other three attacks are all that.
Cool.
Okay, so...
Oh, you son of a gun.
Oh, you never knocked him down.
No, but I have plus one accuracy.
We've been counting that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I've been counting that.
I haven't been.
Alright, so I'm gonna headband this one.
I have trap is on top. The weapon proficiency, accuracy, I was not counting.
Alright.
Trap is on top.
Headband. I'm trying. Gaze of Sorrow. Alright, so the Gaze of Sorrow again is pulls him forward. I think we kind of want that.
I don't have brain damage, man. On Blitz. Oh, he has zero.
He's got the good one, yeah.
He's got nine, yeah, but.
You have to roll less than. Greater than, you have to roll 10.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna do that.
What's the other one do?
That's closest threat in field of view and range, and then it's gonna attack, a lot of attacks. So I think the gaze is good, it's gonna get us all closer.
Oh, yeah. It's the best.
Okay. I am gonna move though.
Who's the furthest now? This?
Yes. Okay.
That's what I'm saying. Do you want to keep him back here to...
Oh, to keep him there? Yeah, that might be a good idea, just in case.
I mean, Annie's out of the fight, yeah. But whatever.
Monster's turn. All threats facing. Now we have to roll. So, misfortune. Okay, so I suffer... it's a light brain injury. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... Okay. Taric, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm down to one brain insanity.
Annie. 6, I move.
Move forward, right?
Down to 5 brain.
Okay. And Blitz. Fine. Okay. And a monster's turn. Doesn't put a gate because they're all on the board. Our turn.
Trap.
Trap is on top. Fortunately, I have to headband it.
Yeah.
I mean, circle it.
Good.
Trap. You know what? We haven't seen yet. Okay. Oh, great. So then both of these. There's a critical here. Archive any number of gate train tiles on the showdown board. If 5 or more are destroyed this way, the monster is knocked down.
Okay.
So that might be a shard.
That's awesome.
Get rid of the gates. Then you could literally pull the trap. I suffer 0 damage.
Okay.
Oh, I would take 1 because he performs Crooked Step.
Everyone, yeah, I know, but we can keep. We know where the trap is at all times.
Right, but I'm gonna be doing the circlet anyway, so I'm gonna find it again.
Okay.
I think.
Okay.
And then over here, if you wound, you gain a scar and +1 strength.
Which is awesome.
He needs scar.
Everyone does.
He needs it to get the... Literally, if he scars and gets the final blow, he's set. So I think this goes on top. He triggers it. Someone else does this. Then I would have to attack here and pull the trap.
Okay.
So it's like, throw a critical, throw a shard.
What if he does 2? And he hits this.
Well, if you just throw the shard.
Are you making him throw a shard on this?
Yeah, because you're guaranteeing the scar plus one strength. You get a bleeding token. But then he's got three dragon treats in a row.
Okay.
That's what we need.
It sucks because then he wants him to get, we want to get everyone with a treat, but then he's never going to be in the camp. He's never going to fight until the last fight. Yeah, and it'll be, all right, I understand. Let's do it.
Right.
I get it.
So that was her.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just going to move like here. Well, he's going to crooked step, right?
After which one?
After the trap. When I pull the trap. And if we don't have to keep... We don't have to pull the trap if you don't want to.
Okay. What's the second one? We're going to throw a shard and then we're going
to
throw another shard
to get rid of all the gates.
Okay. Why do we care?
Of what? Getting rid of the gates?
Yeah. We've only got one more mood coming up. To waste a shard. I mean, we have 9 shards.
Yeah, I guess the only reason you would do that is so then I don't have to worry about the trap card. But if we don't pull the trap...
Don't pull the trap, we're okay.
We don't have to worry about it. And we can keep going through.
But that's the deal, too. If we throw a shard, then the next person can only attack once.
Right.
Not twice.
Yeah, then we're just not...
We're going to sit here for
attacking.
A turn.
Yeah. Yeah.
But then he's still down a few, he's one more wound.
He's down one more wound, and I can just headband.
Yeah.
And set up.
Okay, let's do that then.
Okay, so I'm going to move there. Blitz.
Throwing a shard.
Throwing a shard. So it's an automatic hit.
Oh, it is an automatic hit.
An automatic crit. Well, there's no crit, so it's just an automatic wound on this.
Okay.
So the tyrant smiles down upon you and rakes a clawed finger across your face. Gain the scar. +1 permanent strength. And 1 bleeding token. Archive this card. Okay. So now he has 3 in a row, correct?
Mm-hmm.
The last one is Oracle's Eye.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Which you can...
Here's that founding stone.
Perfect. So that's gone. And now this is you, right? Do you want to move at all? Or I think you still stay there.
I think so. Because if I get knocked back or... he's going the crooked step to where now? He is the furthest.
Yes, but... he is. So I think maybe she just backs up.
She comes over here.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here.
Yeah. And then 1.
And then 1.
Because now she's the furthest.
Right.
And it'll be over here.
Okay, now I'm going to headband. Oh, I got to get rid of a wound. I did not do that. Okay. So I'm going to headband now. There's the mood card, so we don't want that in play.
Right.
So closest threat and field of view. So here's the... So I'm going to go here, go back up, and attack me. He performs crooked step after this, so he'll be over there.
You could move. I mean, she's 3 away.
Oh, yeah, I could go like this.
I mean, you could even be over here, closer this way. So
true. Yeah, I could be right like that. Closest threat in field of view. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Yeah. Okay. There's the bottom. Switches over here. Monster goes. Close to starting field of view. Okay, so speed, it's gonna be 4 speed, hits me on 8s.
1.
1. Guess what? I'm dodging it.
Well, you better.
I'm dodging brain. That.
It's a head injury.
Get it back.
Cool.
Whew. Okay, performs crooked step, which is here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's it. Yeah, with all these gates down. We're in good shape.
Next
this
one
is
the mood.
And we have 1 more before the trap. So I'm still gonna circle it.
Yeah.
All right. So circle it.
Do you?
Start.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. Here's another one with a scar.
Okay.
Perform resonate. Target suffers 5. So whoever attacks him and wounds him gains 5. Brain damage.
Which could be Annie, and she'll be at 0.
Okay. So you attack there, and then do that one. Yeah, maybe we do that.
Why not do this first?
Tyrant is not impressed. The attacker is knocked down and gains 1 bleeding token.
Because
I would rather get a wound and then a possibility of a wound.
Okay.
And I'm going to move closer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
You cannot. He's block line of sight and everything.
There you go. All right, get on in.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's the best spot.
Yep. Come on, Annie. Just roll back.
I threw my sword at him.
2 hits. Oh, you know what? It's first strike, so it doesn't matter.
Oh, okay.
You got to do this one.
Well, both of them are first strike.
No, they are super dense. All right, first strike. First, I think you need a 7 to wound. Or critical.
Critical, but doesn't do
There's anything. No critical, so it's a wound. Okay, yeah. So I'm going to get rid of the wound now. You gain scar,
mm-hmm.
+1 permanent strength, and a bleeding token. Great, great rolling. Now, celestial gauntlet.
That's a failure.
Yeah, sure. 5,
mm-hmm.
6,
7, 8.
7, 8. 9, 10.
Okay, wow, look at that.
It's another wound. Now you suffer 6 brain damage.
5. You said 5.
Oh. Target suffers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sorry, it is 6.
Oh, so now
so it's a light. It's a light.
Light. Yeah.
And you gain destined, but I think you already have destined?
No. The destined disorder?
Yeah, yeah you gain the destined disorder as well.
That sucks.
But that was another wound. He's down to 3 wounds.
Cool.
And it's the intimidate, which pulls him forward, which would hurt for her.
Yeah.
And the unseen horror, which is the regular attack. Okay. And now trap is on top, so we can't do anything else.
No. We got to keep that unseen horror thing not happening, because it'll. She'll be taking it.
She'll be the one that gets attacked. Right. End of her turn. Back her up with 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. I could dash to take the attack. You just have to move first.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do I maybe not hit the portal? Risk a damage somewhere?
Yeah, I think you're okay.
We're just
with taking with
I can take a light.
Down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm gonna take this one.
Okay.
I'm gonna go one away then.
Can you go maybe do this one? Stand there.
Okay. All right.
15. Destroyed. You go adjacent to him.
I'm gonna go behind him, like on the side.
I gotta go here at least.
Okay.
Gonna be adjacent. That's fine. Okay. Now I'm gonna go. We're going to put the attack on top.
Okay.
It's going to perform Crooked Step.
You're going to move anyway, so it doesn't matter.
I can get her closer. So Crooked Step is like right next to us.
That'd be cool.
Okay. So I'm going to headband.
Yeah.
And we're just going to put Unseen Horror on top.
Because that pull, the pull is going to hurt Annie.
Right.
To make her roll.
Yeah, we don't want that to happen. I could still do Aura or Death with her.
Hmm.
But that's one round of not doing the circlet.
Yeah.
So I think we are good with just doing this. So now I'm gonna move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, dash 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See if I can get it back. I do. Dash is that one. And now I'm going to dash with her, because we know Cricket Step is coming.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just gonna go here.
Yeah.
Just to get closer. Okay. It's the end of our turn. Switches. Monster goes, closest starting field of range. So now he backs up. Let's get within range. 4 attacks, hits on 8s. 2 hits.
2 hits, sorry buddy.
That's okay, better than 4. The head, so I'm gonna.
No, feet and waist.
The waist. So I'm gonna dodge the waist. Dodge the waist, so I take 4 damage. I take 3 damage.
You with the +1?
Yep.
Okay.
3 damage to the legs. Form Crooked Step. Here. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Our turn.
Headbands.
Circle it.
Yeah.
Got a crooked step.
What is that?
The death blow.
Wow.
If we played this correctly.
No, we can't. We have to do three wounds.
I know, but we only do one wound here.
Yeah.
Next turn, one wound. Next turn.
Okay.
So if we do one wound, but let's see. So you gain plus one permanent strength, plus two weapon proficiency. Well, see, we need him to do the fate of the killing blow, and it's over. So it doesn't matter if he does death blow or not. Yes, it would be good. He gets plus one permanent strength also, and two weapon proficiency.
Should be great. He'll be there. He's already got one weapon proficiency. Oh, yeah, he'll two from this, or one more.
That would actually be really good if we could do that. But I think in order to do that, we're wasting a lot of shards. See, it's three wounds. You can't pull two attacks. If you pull two attacks, this comes out.
Yeah.
And how many shards do you have? One just shard to end it. Mm-hmm. I've got two shards here.
Or how about you just shoot her? Or you go in with the tank and hit him?
Oh.
You have faded blow, don't you?
I do.
Faded blow on the tank, you do two damage.
Yeah. But I would have to hit. I don't know if I can do faded blow with the founding stone.
With the sword.
Yeah, but I can pull two attacks.
It does roll two?
Yeah.
Shoot with a bow. What does the bow do? One? Or does two, two?
I can't. That was her turn.
Oh, man. Yeah, no, I think it's a waste to get, Oh, no. Look
at this. This gives plus one permanent strength.
This gives you pristine.
Yeah, it's great.
The Faded Blow fighting art, which he doesn't have, which you would then replace with something else.
I think it's worth it to get him jacked.
That'd be cool.
With this, right?
Yeah.
Because we might not use him again, and he'll have weapon proficiency.
And then someone else will get this, which is cool.
Yeah. Alright, so we have three wounds that we have to do. Mm-hmm. So, really...
I'm trying to plan it out the best way to maximize, because we pulled Death Blow.
Yeah.
So how do you get Death Blow on the person that we're going to get
the final
Death Blow with? Hit.
So if this is one shard, she went.
Okay.
So we need someone else to...
The tank.
They don't have a shard.
Nope.
So the tank, but then I don't...
Don't headband.
But it doesn't matter, because we know what's coming out.
I can't get hit with that.
That's okay. I'll move over there.
No, Annie can't get pulled. It's everyone gets pulled in.
No, this is going away. This is the attack.
Oh,
this
okay.
is what's
okay.
coming. So if I threw a founding stone with Taric, I'm going to get plus one permanent strength.
Cool.
And a wound. This is gone.
Yeah.
He's got two wounds left. So then I can go here, take this hit. Next turn, founding stone, game over.
Okay.
Or founding stone.
Stone.
Oh, wait. I would have to do head circlet. Founding stone.
Right.
Doesn't matter. Let's do that.
Okay.
So this is on top.
So he has, Taric has two founding stones. Okay.
Yes.
So we're good.
I think we're okay.
I think.
So you just went. No, she just went. So she's just going to move over a long space.
Get out of the way.
All right. Now it is Taric's turn. So I'm not going to do anyone else's turn to maybe mess things up. So I'm going to throw a founding stone. Yeah, I don't think I can do Faded Blow on this. Who has Faded Blow? Card in front of him. Once per turn, you may give your next wound attempt plus two strength and devastating one. I don't see why I couldn't do it right now.
I don't
now.
See why you couldn't.
My next wound attempt is an automatic.
Right.
So I think
so
I
can... Founding Stone would just do two damage.
Yeah. I'm going to do that.
I don't see why it wouldn't.
Right.
Although it does say you gain two strength, you wouldn't use strength on Founding Stone, but it says you automatically hit.
Spend an act to sling the stone from anywhere on the board. Archive this card for one automatic hit that inflicts a critical wound. Once per turn, you may give your next wound attempt. Well, that's what I'm going to do right now.
Yeah.
Faded Blow, my next wound attempt. Well, I'm just throwing a Founding Stone.
Mm-hmm.
It's automatic. This is two wounds. Blitz has not gone yet, right?
No.
We're going to end it right now.
Okay.
Faded Blow, throw my Founding Stone. Hits. Critical. Two more, I gain plus one permanent strength. So now I have plus two strength.
And the Celestial Sleeves. How that gives you strength, but whatever.
Two wounds.
Two wounds. So now we have one wound left on the monster.
One wound left on the monster. This is Death Blow.
Death Blow.
And then Blitz is throwing
Blitz it. Blitz is going to throw his last Founding Stone that he's carrying with him.
Doesn't... Now let's just say, if I couldn't have done Faded Blow.
Right.
what would happen was I would have came in here, dash if I needed to get within range, blocked one attack.
Right.
Next turn, I would have had to have circled it again. Top wound might have even given me another bonus.
Right.
But we're not going to do that. But that's what... Roll... I'm going to roll 4 attacks to see. Still 8's to hit. One hit, I could dodge it.
Dodge.
So I'm not going to mess up anything. All right. You're just going to throw it. Throw that last founding stone for Blitz.
Yeah. It's thrown. Death blow.
Automatic wound.
Cool.
The tyrant staggers, clutching his chest as glowing ichor spills from the wound. A hush falls over the settlement as the survivors observe the slowly spreading smile on the fearsome benefactor's lips. The one that dealt the killing blow is exalted by the tyrant. They gain +1 permanent strength.
Is that +3, which does more.
Which is a trait.
Yeah. So let's give you that first. Okay.
+2 weapon proficiency.
Okay, so he goes boom, boom. He hits 3 with axes.
Faded blow fading art.
Now that would replace something else.
So what does he have there now?
Strategist, which is putting down something on the teller, yep, on the board. Peerless is when you gain insanity, you also gain survival of that. And Rhythm Chaser, which is pretty crappy on you.
Get rid of Rhythm Chaser.
Okay.
And the Pristine Ability. When you suffer dismembered severe injury, ignore it and gain a bleeding token instead. That's just an ability, so it's not fighting her. That's it. He is dead. Let's just see if I had to have circulated, what would we have gotten?
Boom, right here.
No scar.
Right with that, he then has 4 in a row.
Oh, with Pristine, huh?
With Pristine. Because we gain Faded Blow and Pristine.
Whoa. Okay.
So how does that work? Because he also killed him, so do we...
Well, how does that
resolve? Because I'm sure you can only have 1.
Yes, I think we're going to decide.
Okay. Because we're assuming once we kill him, you also gain a trait. And gaining that trait, which we believe is going to be Oracle's Eye, finishes another row.
Okay, so... The star that dealt the killing blow is brought before the tyrant with its glowing fist. It reaches into the survivor's bruised flesh, tearing away their very essence with a ripping, searing sound. The star may gain Iridescent Hide or Oracle's Eye. So, what 4 do we in a row do we have right now?
We have Gambler.
Okay. If we...
If we went with Oracle's Eye, we would gain Witch. However, if we don't, we go with Iridescent Hide. Iridescent Hide itself is a good ability. I don't know what Oracle's Eye is.
That was like, I think you get to look at the top card of the AI deck.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're deciding. Let's see.
Is that a,
Oracle's Eye. The start of the showdown, look through the AI deck, then shuffle it. So you see what the cards are.
That's pretty cool.
Yes.
The first time you fight a monster, Oracle's Eye is pretty sweet.
Right.
Or do you go with Iridescent Hide, which is...
that extra armor.
Which is going to give you extra armor, yeah.
Since I would have said Oracle's Eye if you didn't gain the 4 in a row from something else.
Can we? If we can pick, then we might want to...
We won't know what they do until we...
Yeah, until we decide. So it's going to be either a Gambler or a Witch.
So it's Witch or Gambler with Iridescent Hide.
Yeah.
Or obviously Witch with Oracle's Eye. He is your character. I want to let you decide on this.
Yeah, I wonder. I don't know. So people, if you picked... Well, I'm going to pick one now, but if you know... what you would have picked, let us know. But I think I'm just going to stay with Witch and gain the Iridescent Hide ability.
Okay. I was just going to say, do we have anyone close to doing the one or the other? Like, if we're not going to get Witch ever again, then yeah, let's pick Witch. Like, what's harder to get?
Well, Witch is going to be 9 Understanding and Oracle's Eye. I mean, we have Annie who's missing both of those. Mm-hmm. If she gets 9 Understanding, she's also a gambler.
Oh, because she has the top row?
She's got the top row.
Oh, she has Pristine and everything?
Yeah.
So she just needs 9 Understanding and she's set.
She needs Oracle's Eye as well. We're pretty much all in the same kind of boat.
Yeah.
Right? How much Understanding she has?
Oh, so...
Yeah, she's really far from getting Witch.
All right.
Or Gambler. She's really far from those. Although she's really close to base. The banks, the 3 base strength.
Mm-hmm. You're going with who?
I think I'm going to go with the Gambler because we're going to keep Iridescent Hide.
Oh, so you're going with Gambler? And yeah. keeping your iridescent hide.
We'll take the iridescent hide, because then it'll actually be useful. Because yeah. that iridescent hide,
that's
again,
extra
is
armor. That's
one great. Armor per different color.
Right, so you could have two or three by the end of the...
Is it per color or just per
match? Per color. Per color. Per okay. different color.
It's kind of crappy to think about.
I think that's actually pretty cool.
I mean, we got two armor. And end the game, what's two armor?
Two armor to every hit location?
Yeah.
It's like having a souped-up shield.
I was falling asleep. Yeah, I guess.
I think that's awesome.
All right, let's do that.
Okay, so gambler with iridescent hide. Mm-hmm. Okay, plus each victorious survivor gains one random fighting art. So okay. so he'll gain another fighting art, which Great. Could be.
Yeah, he's got pretty decent.
Another trait, yeah. but we don't really need right. it. And then she over here she'll gain one.
Cool.
So let's do that. Let's do that now. Fighting arts. Put them all back in.
So that was pretty good. We got one person right now already with a complete dragon trait.
Right. So.
So that's really good.
Now we have to see like how good that is, like what that actually
what
does.
What that does, yeah. We have other people pretty close to that. Annie's one or two away for a couple of them, you know. So I think we're on track. I mean, year 10, we have 15 years more to get more traits on people.
Yeah. All right. Fighting art for... Well, is there a dragon trait fighting art he wants instead? Or does he like the three he has? Does
well,
he have
really,
feet to blow?
He can get... Yeah, he's already got that. We can get champions right. That's really it. But I kind of like strategists. Or strategists.
Me too.
Say. It's kind of neat. We're unbreakable. Unbreakable is a piece of junk. Unbreakable sucks.
You block your first severe injury.
To get rid of strategist or peerless. When you gain insanity, you gain survival, which I think is awesome.
Which is one save. If we're using him...
For the final fight?
If that's what it is, yeah.
Yeah.
Then he gets one complete block. Because we're not going to use him for any other fight.
Right.
If that's the thing.
Well,
so using strategist and whatnot would only come into play for the last fight, mm-hmm. but if that person, let's say his other teammates, maybe they have champions right, and they're just going to use that right away. I don't know.
Yeah.
You decide, actually.
Peerless is pretty cool, and there's no other way to get it, I don't think. I mean, we okay. kind of got that weird. We're going to go with where no one's getting hurt in the final fight, so we're gonna go with...
Keeps the way it is?
Yeah.
Okay. So we don't even need to pull him.
Pull one for him. Never know. Make it good. We don't want it.
It was unbreakable, right?
Yeah.
That's funny. All right, so Annie, she's just going to get whatever comes out. Now, she's already full, right? She has three fighting arts.
Yeah, which are really good. She has ambidextrous, red fist, and faded blow. Pull trailblazer. The hunting party may start the hunt phase one bit closer to the monster. That's pretty good.
That is pretty cool.
At the start, all survivors gain one survival and up to one insanity, which is pretty good.
I think those are better.
I think mine are better.
Yeah. Having those ambidextrous. Yeah. Fated blow is great.
Yeah.
Taric. Berserker. Once per showdown, you may spend action to suffer bash and the frenzy. That kind of sucks. I'm not going to...
Because he's already full.
He's full. And then Misfortune. She has dragon investment, so I'm going to give her... Oh, she has fated blow.
And champions.
And champions, right. I'm gonna give her one so I can get the. Oh.
You can get unbreakable.
I am gonna take unbreakable just to circle it up. Yeah.
I mean, does she have any other crappy things? Maybe just pull a fighting art. I know you
want
to get.
I want the circle.
Yeah, but it's crap. It's. You're not even close to anything else there.
Plus three base strength. Oh yeah.
Does she have any crappy fighting art? It's trying to min max.
Orator of death.
No, keep. I'd say give her a chance. The unbreakable.
Unbreakable.
It's pretty crappy, the dragon investments, now you think about it, because...
Well, it's good to start with.
Yeah, it's great to start with, because it gives you something.
Now you want to move it over to people that don't. Someone else. Yeah. Also, we gain the Celestial Spear rare gear.
Oh, sweet. Ah, oh, man, we don't have anyone. Well, I hope that's a grand weapon.
That'd be cool.
I hope not, because she's got two weapons now.
Oh, yeah.
Celestial Spear. I wonder what that... That's obviously like a spear or lance.
All right. Reach two.
Cool.
Okay. Two attacks, hits on fives, four strength. Gain plus five strength when attacking with this weapon if you have a constellation. So it would be nine strength on Blitz. Pretty cool.
Wow.
Nine strength on Blitz. Yeah, that's it. Wow. It really was, so we keep the gates out, but just as long as you get through the wounds, like they don't come into play, it wasn't that bad.
Yeah.
Well, and we had someone that could dodge all those attacks.
Mm-hmm.
Keep them all grouped up, dash around, have the tank hit, evasion tank, and don't worry about the gates.
Yeah, with eight evasion, that was really good.
Yeah.
You know, we weren't getting hit as much.
Yeah, that was good. We got a lot of bonuses. He's one away from plus three strength. He would need the courage and...
Yeah, that fight went well. We didn't run into really any problems.
Yeah.
Few hits, but not really. I think the last Gorm we fought was provided more damage to us. And
yeah, I agree. So it's just going to be a quick settlement phase. We go back. We didn't get any extra resources, so we're going to have four endeavors, which I guess just kids unfortunately.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, set it up. Alright, back to the settlement with our four survivors. First, we've got a few things in order that we have to do for this year, even though we don't really have any resources. Two people actually leveled up with age, one being Misfortune. That's our first level up, right?
Yeah.
So I'm going to roll with her against the age. So she is now weapon proficient. Ooh, plus one permanent strength.
That's pretty good. That's our... Like our utility or our bow person.
Plus
so
one strength. Good. That's cool. And Annie
this the is grand her weapon master. This is her
reflex.
Sixth.
Yep, improved reflexes here.
12?
Plus one permanent strength.
Okay, well that gives her plus three.
That's a dragon trait.
That is a trait.
Wow.
Okay.
I like it. Alright, age is out of the way. So now we are returning, so we have to do the random event. Just one. A six. One, two, three, four, five. Can you say that for me?
Oh, yeah, sure, it's easy. Glossolalia.
Okay. Glossolalia.
Or glossolai. Glossolai. I'm going to say glossolai.
Okay. The settlement calls out to the returning survivors in a chorus of unknown tongues. Each survivor in the settlement begins to speak in their own incomprehensible language until all the sound of the settlements are replaced with a never-ending babble.
Oh, boy.
Nominate one survivor.
Survivor from town or returning survivor?
Doesn't have to be a returning survivor.
Okay, so anyone in town. Let's just pick someone in town.
Should it just be Sivir?
No, why?
We always use her as like your guinea pig.
But she's not a guinea pig.
Okay.
Let's use Jinx.
Or maybe like Leona, because we were trying to build her up.
But I don't know what it does. Man.
I don't know yet either. You're
making people like talk blabble. I'm not sending anyone out there that I know. Send those noobs out. I say send someone we don't know.
Okay. Oh, you know what? How about someone that we've used, but we don't really use anymore?
Well, we still use, but not as much.
Right. All right, let's see. We've got Leona who... What about, like, Thresh?
Sure.
All right, Thresh.
Just not one of our, you know, big guys.
Maybe. Okay, let's see. Nominate one survivor, and then I think you have to roll a die. Go ahead.
Just one?
Yep. 10. The nominated survivor words carry above all others. As they speak, the others begin to learn the language impossibly fast. The nominated survivor gains plus two understanding and adds the title Father of Words to their name. Your settlement may endeavor at science and education innovations normally this settlement phase. Okay, so he's a father of something or other. And
that's
plus cool. Two understanding, I said?
Yeah.
Okay, he's got two understanding.
Yippee!
That would have been good from anyone else.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so yeah, it prevents education and science endeavors, but whatever. But look, there's new endeavors here. Automatic writing.
You write the story of death, gain a disorder, gain two insanity. If you roll a 10, you gain a crazed fighting art. That's kind of crazy. And then deep listen, spend two resources. Without language distracting, the settlement learns their blah, blah, blah. The parting stars gain plus one movement token. So our next fight, we could have an extra movement.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, two resources.
Especially with the mana.
That's kind of silly. All right, that's that.
So what did that do?
We gained two understanding.
Okay.
Because we learned a language.
All right, I'm stealing this. I want to just see what this does.
Yeah, now we know.
We gained this only for this turn. Oh, this is dumb.
We probably could have... Now we know we could nominate someone to gain the understanding. I don't think there's anything bad on there.
Yeah.
All right, warm climate. It's my turn to roll, right?
Oh, yeah.
5.
That's good.
Same thing. Plus 2 endeavor results to home innovations this year.
Cool.
All right, got through the settlement phase. Okay, now we're going to do, since we have Blitz, right?
Yes, he is have a complete constellation.
So let's show the picture here. Faces in the sky. Suddenly a second heartbeat pulses in your eardrum. A second spirit roars in your breast. You look up, locking eyes with an enormous shrouded face, visible to your eyes only. It is the face of the stars, and you are one of the people of the stars. When a survivor gains all dragon traits in a row, great, 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 great. Okay. In the moment of rebirth, the people of the stars may consume their lies or sins. Choose one. Remove all permanent injuries and gain the vestophobia disorder, meaning he can get rid of anything that's really hurting him permanent-wise.
Okay.
But vestophobia means that you can't depart with any gear in your chest piece, so that's kind of silly.
That's dumb.
So let's not do that.
Okay.
But the other one is remove all disorders. Does he have any disorders?
He has destined and quixotic.
Quixotic's pretty cool.
Jinx. Yeah.
But then you gain the broken jaw, severe head injury, which is... Let's see. You can no longer encourage.
So this is something we have to do. It's not something I can say, you know what, I would like to do one or the other.
Right.
I don't have an option.
Yeah, see, I was
nothing.
Thinking, like, it's silly. It says...
I should have the option of doing nothing.
They may consume their lives or sins, but then it says choose one. So it would be great if you didn't have to choose either. Because we don't want to consume either of your lives or sins.
Yeah.
So maybe we will find out going forward. If someone else can say we don't have to choose one, then I don't think we do, because we want that quixotic.
Yeah, he has nothing wrong with him. He's been fine. So
yeah.
Why would I want to choose one?
If we have to choose one.
I could see if you... Yeah. Maybe if he had no disorders, that'd be one thing. Because then it's like, you know what? You don't have any permanent abilities or impairments. You have no disorders. You can't.
Yeah.
Maybe
people stars may consume their lives. Yeah, because I would say let's not.
I don't want to do it, yeah.
But if we have to, I would say you don't want the vestophobia, because that completes all your armor sets.
Yeah, no.
So you would lose your disorders and gain broken jaw. So
yeah. That's
what we'll go with.
Unless
we don't have to.
Right.
Okay. When a survivor gains the constellation, the experience alters the very fiber of their being. The celestial face of the vision becomes a mirror, and they the reflection. Draw the constellation card that corresponds to the constellation the survivor gained. Record the rules and abilities associated with it and adjust your permanent attributes as listed.
Wow.
So here is the gambler card.
Remember the gambler.
No idea what any of these cards are.
I'm really excited to flip this card.
I'm excited to see it. Hopefully it's not just gain 2 insanity.
Well, I'm hoping it's a gambler. You know, you look at what the traits are and stuff. Gambler, maybe luck, which would be great because he's proficient in axes, which is deadly. Maybe, like, I only need a 6 or more to crit.
Yeah.
But
all right, ready? For the first people to start... Blitz. Oh, there's a lot of words on
that's
here.
A lot of words. Record all that, yeah.
Okay. A face with a jaw splits in two, stares down at you. Its chin curves away from each other, each with their own mouth. You find on each of your hands a second middle finger.
Oh, that's wonderful.
They move independently and prevent your hands from touching.
Huh? But your hand, like...
Heal all dismembered arm permanent injuries. Gain
another arm.
100 insanity. The immortal disorder and the following ability. Now, Snots probably doesn't know what the immortal disorder does. So
I have an idea. You can't die, maybe? Or you don't age?
Let me get it out for you.
Okay. So let me write down 100. That's pretty cool. I mean, it's cool, but it's pretty cool. 100 insanity.
Immortal. You are immortal. You will live forever, cannot be killed. While you are insane, convert all damage dealt to your hit locations to brain damage.
Wow!
You are so busy in your own glory, reveling in your own glory, that you cannot spend survival while insane.
Okay.
So you can't spend survival, but you have 100 armor. That's pretty crazy.
That's pretty cool.
That's pretty cool. Okay, and here's your special ability. 12 fingers. You cannot carry two-handed gear. That sucks.
That's horrible. That's his whole thing, yeah.
And that spear is two-handed, isn't it?
I think so.
On a
anyway.
Let's see.
No, it is not.
Okay. Well, that's good to know.
The celestial spear, yeah.
Okay. On a perfect hit, your right hand pulses. Gain 5 insanity and +1 luck for the attack. However, for each natural run, one rolled while attempting to hit, your left hand shakes. Suffer 5 brain damage and -1 luck for the attack. Okay.
Pretty crap.
The whole point is you're immortal with 100 insanity.
Okay.
That's pretty cool.
That's neat.
I think that's different.
Yeah, I think that's kind of cool.
Right? Okay. And we have one person, people of stars. That's exciting. I didn't think actually would ever happen. I think getting the traits are hard.
So I can't get, a severe injury.
Well, all your damage is just going to go to...
Right, because... Oh, it's like armor. Okay.
Yep.
Right. Okay.
Yep. Until you're down, and then it just goes to your street.
I wonder what... Oh, I guess it's kind of neat for the last fight.
Yeah.
You know?
That's awesome. Okay. So that's the first one. Let's see. Just for a heads up, they're... actually, I have to stay over here. Just for a heads up, they're... The Manhunter, we're going to have a special Manhunter showdown this year, so that's what's going to be the next video, even though it takes place in the same time frame. Okay, so we're going to update the timeline, and Manhunter is here. I believe he's going to be a level 2.
Ugh. I'm worried about him, yeah.
And we have a story event this year. Unveil the Sky. Which is... Ooh. This right here.
I guess we all
look up and see what's going on.
Yeah, it's like Encounters of the Fourth Kind or whatever, you know.
Or like Ghostbusters, right?
No, the aliens like to suck you up into their thing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Reality is shattered, revealing the teeming depths of limitless night. The celestial vault is thrown open to reveal the world beyond. Oh, that is kind of scary. Look at all the faces up there.
Yeah.
The light shatters the... delicate boundaries of the survivor's world. In silent benediction and judgment, the celestial faces gaze upon the tyrant's people, commanding them to race for their destinies. Nominate 4 survivors with at least 1 dragon trait. They gain 2 understanding and pure destiny. And it looks like we have to roll a d10. And it looks like we could gain
stuff.
Traits.
Okay. Okay.
And we could die.
And possibly die.
Right. Okay.
It's always a possibility to die.
What's the name of the game?
Kingdom.
Yeah, okay. Alright, so who are we thinking? I think Taric and Misfortune, people that are close to gaining another 4 in a row.
And I'm picking Sivir and Ziggs. They're pretty close. They both have 2 or 3. They can use some other stuff, so I'm hoping.
Okay.
You roll Taric or whatever. You roll your people. Just get them good.
Alright. Misfortune. Gotta start with Lucky.
Okay.
6. So she gains 2 understanding.
Cool.
Which is great. That means she's at 6 now. You are certain one of the faces above is mouthing your name. A distant voice whispers the tale of your death. Gain 3 courage. So 1, 2, 3. That's gonna pop her on the courage list.
Okay.
And the noble surname, which I don't have.
Cool.
So that's great.
That's pretty useful.
I'm gonna finish misfortune out.
Yeah.
All right. Understanding. No, courage. 8 on courage.
Pretty good.
+1 permanent accuracy.
Awesome.
And unbreakable fighting art. Hey, it's a dragon trait.
Oh, okay.
Which I already have.
Yeah. Get your accuracy, man.
I'll get that +1 permanent accuracy.
Whoa.
I'm already at +1 permanent accuracy.
So can you go as 2?
I sure can. +2 accuracy. That's pretty helpful.
That's awesome. Especially for being a utility. Yeah, that's always going to hit that arrow now.
Yeah. All right, unveil the sky. Taric walks up. 5. Same thing.
Okay.
So I gain the 2 understanding, I gain the 3 courage, and I gain noble.
That's great.
So he's got 2 in a row there, and now I'm going to roll on mine, because I just gained courage. I'll take another 8.
Yeah, 8 would be great.
Or 2 in the settlement phase, intimacy, and +1 to your roll result if possible, nominate yourself. So he's got to have kids.
Okay, that's fine. That's what we were going to do.
Right, so we'll remember that then.
Okay.
He's going to do kids. He gets +1 on the intimacy result.
Sweet. Right. I will roll for Sivir as she walks up to unveil the sky. 8.
8. A voice, gain 2 understanding.
1, 2.
Okay. A voice above loudly declares your perfect ancestry. Gain 2 ranks of weapon proficiency.
Well, she's at 0, so, okay.
Okay. She's old enough to actually do that, right?
Yeah, she's 2.
Okay.
Don't say... Keep going.
What, weapon?
No, that's good.
And the reincarnated surname.
Well, she's already reincarnated.
That's the only one that we didn't need her to get.
Yeah.
Okay. 2 ranks of weapon proficiency. What weapon was she going to do? Do we know?
Oh, I don't know. We'll figure it out when we get there.
Okay. We should know now, but it's
okay.
Oh,
we should know now?
We'll decide.
Okay, we'll decide later.
It doesn't really...
And Zig says he...
Walks up.
Wanders up.
3. Your life has purpose. You will achieve your master's work in 5 insanity and the destined disorder.
He's already got destined.
Well,
which sucks because destined means you have to go out and fight again.
Or you lose all your insanity.
Or the insanity that I just gained goes away.
So that's he gained 2 understanding.
Oh, okay. You know what? That does nothing.
Gets him close, right?
Yeah, he's at 7 understanding.
Okay.
I was a complete waste of time.
Mine were good.
Good, I rolled.
Woo!
Good thing it was now.
A 10 would have been the Frozen Star Secret Fighting Art.
Ah, man.
But a 1 would have died, so no one died.
Yeah, no one died. That's
and
that way.
Sivir and Taric, I mean, Taric and Misfortune, they did pretty well.
Yeah. I mean, nothing was not useful, let's say that.
Yeah, let's put it that way. All right, so now we have 4 endeavors. So let's start with Taric first, because... You automatically go. So Taric and
Misfortune.
Well, they could both die. Oh, we add +1 to the results.
Yeah.
So let's do Taric and Misfortune.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll roll and you roll. Okay. So at an 11 or an 8. For intimacy.
Might as well just keep having kids, because what he wants to do is throw them up to the throne to hopefully get a new, whatever they're called, I can't remember now.
Innovations. Okay. So we can have +1 population, and they choose a dragon inheritance, or we can have someone come out with Iridescent Hide or Oracle's Eye.
Right. So let's roll.
We can pick. We pick either or.
Oh.
We already got it.
Oh, okay.
So...
Oracle's Eye. Oracle's Eye, man.
New person with Oracle's Eye?
Yeah.
I choose 1 dragon inheritance. Yeah, I guess let's just do that.
We don't have anyone with Oracle's Eye.
Okay, so I'm gonna take... Oh, look, we've got Olaf over here. He's a new person, which is noble. He's gonna go up. He's gonna go up and talk.
All right.
So let's do...
You're in charge, because I can't think.
A male... Wow, yeah, I haven't played in a little while. A male...
Who's the guy that throws the blades out? Old.
Talon?
Yeah.
Okay. Talon with Oracle's Eye.
I haven't played League in like 2 years. think I still have like 10 bucks in riot points.
Okay. Now we have four endeavors, and there's nothing else we can do. We don't have enough to innovate.
We just keep having children.
We're just going to keep rolling for having children. So does anyone close to getting 9 understanding? Have them roll to maybe gain
Ziggs is at Ziggs is at 7.
How about Misfortune?
Okay.
She's at 6, but she's closer with traits than him, right?
Yeah.
9 understanding. I don't really do much. Actually, I think Taric would be better.
But we don't have the resources to spend.
Right. But we have to spend it if we roll it.
Yeah.
So do we just not spend any...
Send someone up to the throne. All right,
send someone up to the throne. Did you roll last time?
I am not rolling.
All right, Olaf. Oh, I rolled last time. Do it.
I am not sending anyone up to the throne.
Olaf.
He doesn't die, at least.
He does not die. Man, too bad we can't do this more than once. This is what I would do all the time. Once per settlement. They suffer blind, severe head injury, and gain the scar.
He's blind, though.
Who cares? Blind and scar.
He's not going to be able to see.
Okay.
Okay. So
three more. So don't have kids?
I don't know what else to do. That's the thing. What else can we do with the endeavors? We don't have...
to really do the endeavors.
We don't have the resources to possibly roll for children to waste on the understanding. You know? So... I don't know what else we do with the endeavors that we have left over.
We have a skull and a broken lantern that we could possibly depart with.
We can get rid of the skull.
Yeah.
We need the broken lantern because we need the scrap.
Yeah. I'd say let's try and get someone at least one.
All right, let's do it with her then.
Misfortune. 6, 7. She gains a survival.
Okay.
This is our
two more
third
left.
Endeavor. Yeah, third and fourth. Same thing. And last one, same thing. She gained a lot of survival.
Yeah.
Until we can spend our endeavors on something else. That's it. But hey, we made it through. We still have to fight the Manhunter. He's waiting for us.
Yep.
But we've got one person as people of Stars.
Yeah.
So we're almost there. Almost. I don't really know where we're going. We're just trying to get as many people off course as people of Stars. We got some. Misfortune and Taric are close. Annie's pretty beefy right now, right?
I mean, we got Blitz is done. Annie's pretty close, and she's pretty strong. So, I mean, we're doing pretty well.
Yeah.
It should be a good fight coming up, even though this time when we fight him, it's going to be much different because now there's, like, certain things that we changed, we did differently in the last fight, and he's a whole lot harder.
Yeah, the Manhunter.
It's going to be a whole lot harder. He's got traps or something now, right?
I think he starts at level 3 and 4, he has traps.
Okay. So traps,
yeah. I don't know.
It's going to be a rough fight.
Yeah, who do we bring out? Do we bring out really strong people?
Yeah.
Then we're going to have to fight a level 2 Gorm, I think.
Possibly.
When we come back. And then do we send these four beefy guys
Charles,
out?
I know you're going to say go fight like a level 4 Gorm. So that's not what we're going to do when we get done with that.
So, all right. Thanks for watching. And we'll see you the next time when we fight the Manhunter.
Yeah.
Take care.